what's your understanding that you have of me, you and I? So, oh yeah, this is what somebody wants to do. Oh, this is what somebody... You, what do you want to do? You, what do you want to do? So, that's number one. What do you want to achieve? We're talking about preparing for next year. What are you trusting God for? So, now, after you have listed all those things, they could be 10, 20, 50. These are the things. Now, some just do that and that is it. No. The next thing is, how do you want to achieve it? Or how do you want to achieve them? It's easy to dream. It's easy. Anybody can dream. You can lie down on your bed and dream. But then, how are you trusting God? These lofty dreams and ideas, how are you trusting God to achieve them? Don't forget the scripture that I quoted and paraphrased. Whoever wants to build a house, whoever wants to go to war, will force it down. So, how are you going to achieve what you want to achieve? Not just wishful thinking. It's not enough to talk about it. Talking is different from doing. Wishing. There is a difference between dreamers and achievers. Everybody is a dreamer. Everybody. Every human being. Because if you don't dream, you can't achieve. Everybody is a dreamer. But there's a difference between a dreamer and an achiever. The difference is doing. It's taking a step. Everybody can sit down with, oh, I wish this, I wish that, oh, I dream that, I wish this. And to that level, 90% of people dream. Whether they say it or not, it doesn't matter. 95% of people dream. They desire things. Some desire that I just open my door now and then I just see 10 million pounds. Dreams. Wishful thinking. Oh, I just wish I had that house. You drive past a house and so beautiful. And say, oh, I wish I had this as my property. Okay, fine. It may not be only you that driven past that house and wished for it. You see a car. Wow, this is a beautiful car. Oh, I wish I had this car. Fine. It may not be, you may not be the only one who wished for that car. The difference is, out of about 100 people that passed by that house or that car or that business or read about that billionaire, out of 100, maybe 2 will take a step and say, how do I get this car? How do I get this kind of property? It may take me 1 month. It may take me, it may, but how do I? That's why at the beginning of the year you have a lot of resolutions. They call it New Year resolutions. It's easy to talk. This year, this next year, I won't do this again. I won't do that again. I won't do that again. Yes, some people don't have what they want to achieve. Well, I'm giving you a three-step plan here. Now, the first one is to even identify what you want to achieve. That's good. Because some are even going through the year without identifying what they want to achieve. Without identifying what things they want to, that should be better in their lives. Some are just grateful. Oh, I have a new year. I have a new year and that's it for them. But as good as that is not the best. Because you have to take a step further to say, how do I want to achieve this? Because as you sit down to articulate how you want to achieve it, things become clearer for you. That's why new resolutions for many people don't last. Because they just said it, that they didn't put in place any plan as to how to make the resolutions come to pass. So somebody says, oh, this year I will stop drinking. And you promised And don't forget, you are sincere in your promise. I give you that. You are sincere in your promise. But then you didn't sit down and say, am I going to achieve? The first thing is that I'll stop going to pubs. You didn't articulate your steps. So by January ending, you find you and your friends going to pubs, going to hotels, to restaurants, to beer parlor, and then you are tempted again because you did not articulate how you want to achieve. I'm just giving this very simple, simplistic example. All right? So it's not enough to wish for something. And that's why we find a lot of religious Christians, if I may use those words, religious Christians who pray, who fast. Some are having 30 days fasting. Wonderful. Some are having marathon. Great. But that is not enough. That is not enough. Jesus planned.